Hi guys, and welcome back to SwitchUp. Now, we haven't done a list like this ever. This is probably our first real accessory list on the Nintendo Switch, and we thought we'd make it hopefully quite a good one. These are the top things that perhaps you might want to pick up if you've just bought yourself a Nintendo Switch and need the essentials. Lovely, so you've just gone out, you've snagged yourself the new model Switch with the better battery life, and now you need something to carry everything in. We had these cases sent to us from Power A, and in fact it came with the case and the bag all together. These are excellent. I use this every single day. I can get my iPad in there as well as my Switch, and the case is quite sturdy as well. Glen, you are a physical collector, so you'd probably add something else into this as well, wouldn't you?
Yeah, so as well as a case to carry your Switch in, you'd want something to carry your games in. So of course you can get yourself a Switch carry case that has game holders in, and thankfully most of them come with that. But you can also grab yourself additional Switch game holders.
We'll put a few links down in the description of some of the good ones that we use. We are not affiliated with any of these products. We don't get anything for that. That's just something hopefully to help you out. The next thing that you're going to want to purchase, absolutely, is a micro SD card. Now, as good as the Switch is, the internal memory isn't great, especially when you look at a game like Wolfenstein, and straight away you need the SD card, because I think that's over 30 gigs. You can get some good ones on places like Amazon, but I'm going to recommend a slightly strange hack here. I got my 512 gigabyte micro SD card for around about £50, I think that's about $60, through AliExpress. Now, that might make some of you run away in terror, but actually there's review-based legitimate resellers on there, and it comes straight from factory. I had no issues at all and saved myself an absolute wedge. The next of our items is a lot more obscure and not something that perhaps most Switch owners are going to have, and it's called the Genki. Now, what this essentially does is it plugs into your USB-C port on the Switch and then converts the audio into a Bluetooth signal so that you can use a Bluetooth headset. What is also in the box is a little adapter so that you can then use voice chat with your headset as well. This works really well for games like Fortnite and others that support voice chat natively. One area that you may be concerned about is input lag. This does support the quicker ATPX and Bluetooth 5 standards, so you have very little input lag at all. This is a slightly pricier product, but I went back to my little AliExpress roots and found another option that was about $10, and it essentially does the same thing, it just doesn't look nearly as nice. All links will be down below.
Next up, then, you might want to get yourself a controller. Now, of course, the obvious choice is the official Pro Controller, although this is fairly expensive, and if I'm being completely honest, it's not one of Nintendo's best, especially when it comes to the D-pad. There are other options available. We should be at this moment flashing up a couple of these on the screen for you, one by Power A and one by Hikarus. So the first MB in the Power A comes with additional buttons on the back that you can program to perform actions for you so that you have them at the press of a button, funnily enough. Things you may want to consider though is that this one doesn't have HD rumble and it does take two AA batteries to use. Having said that, of course, it's about half the price of the official controller.
Yeah, I actually use this controller loads. I found a few games where the button placement just wasn't quite right, and being able to program that rear button has been very useful indeed. Not having HD rumble is a bit of a loss, but it does have gyro controls, so that's there. The other controller that we've looked at is called a Hikarus, I believe. The real selling point here is that you have the programmable turbo buttons on there. I didn't particularly like the analog stick on this one, but overall it's an okay controller if you cannot afford to go for the Pro version, because it does have the HD rumble, it does have every other feature that the Pro controller has, and perhaps arguably a slightly better D-pad. As anyone knows who's played with a mouse and keyboard on a game like Fortnite, playing with a controller is just a worse experience. Now, Hikarus also offer the C91, I believe it's called, which allows you to plug in any mouse and keyboard and then use those for any game, and I really mean any game. It obviously works better with a first-person shooter, and I've tried this with Realm Royale and Fortnite, but you can also then use it in strategy games as well, and it does feel much more natural compared to the controller. This also allows you to do the same on other consoles, PS3, Xbox, PS4, and Xbox One, so it's not just limited to the Nintendo Switch. One other question you may have about it is binding of keys. You can rebind the keys using the software on a PC, or you can just use the defaults, which are set up for games like Fortnite, Paladins, and the aforementioned Realm Royale.
Some further options then for controller support, and this comes by way of a device called, wait for it, the SwitchUp, funnily enough. Nothing to do with us, I must say. This is a USB device that you put into the side of your Switch, and you can then attach your PlayStation 3, Xbox 360, PlayStation 4 or Xbox One controllers to your Switch and use them for your games. Now, I was pleasantly surprised at how quick and easy this was to use. I tried it on my PS4 controller, and the syncing setup is as simple as putting your controller into Bluetooth mode, pressing the button on the side of the USB stick and waiting about 10 seconds for it to sync.
I would say, yeah, Glenn, it's surprising how many people have spare controllers sat around. It also works with an Xbox controller if you have the wireless dongle, the original one, or the Xbox One controller that already has that built into it. It just worked flawlessly. No remapping of buttons, no silly fiddling, you just put your controller on and you can play. Now, there is another element to the SwitchUp dongle. They've included some hacks, if you want to put it that way, for certain games. A bit like back in the day, you had your little Game Genie cartridge that you plugged into your console and then you clicked the game into it as well. Some of you remember that if you're as old as we are. And here you'll have things like allowing you to get infinite moons in Mario, if that's what you're into. Now, that element we haven't used a great deal as an optional extra. For us, it's really about that controller use because it just works so well and saves you potentially quite a bit of money. Plus that name, yes please. Now, it's a dangerous topic to talk about Joy-Cons, I won't say anything, but they're definitely something that you may wish to replace at certain times, and buying the official Joy-Cons can be a touch risky. Now, a while back, I bought this set of unofficial Joy-Cons straight off of AliExpress, and they were around about £15, I believe, which is a fraction of the cost of even one official Joy-Con, and they do the job just fine. They're not the best. The one major limitation of them is perhaps the battery life. They last around about 4, maybe 5 hours when they're undocked, but obviously you click them on and they charge up like any other Joy-Con. They're a bit lighter, they feel a bit cheaper, but the analog stick, I've had no drift, that's for sure. And the rumble, while not HD, is just fine. These Joy-Cons also fit into most normal Switch cases despite having the slight curvature to them. For the price you're going to pay here, it might be worth picking a set of these up just to be your player 2 or your fallback if certain issues should arise. Which takes me on to perhaps my last obscure item on the list, and that's Joy-Con grips. Now, I have massive hands. I've got big hands.
Why have you given me the mic? What do you expect me to say to that?
Yeah, good point. Good point. That was a bit weird, wasn't it? But I've got big hands, and using the little tiny Joy-Cons is quite cramp-inducing, even after a short playtime. So I went out and bought myself a variety of different Joy-Con grips with varying levels of success. Here are a few of them on the screen, and even with the smaller ones, they do a good job of just adding a little bit extra to grip onto. Now, the larger ones, they're not going to work for everyone, but they still allow you to dock your Switch. Just don't try getting them into the case. Quite an obvious one is the need for potentially some form of power bank. Now, I found this really nice one on Amazon that you can actually dock your Nintendo Switch into. It does all your fast charging and everything. It gives you around about 10,000 milliamp hours of extra battery life. I've taken it away on camping, and you can charge your Switch around about 2 times, so you can essentially triple your battery life. Just make sure when you purchase a power bank that it supports the charging that the Nintendo Switch requires, because it does need quite a bit of juice to properly charge it.
So that brings us to the final item on our list, and this one could be the major investment that you need to work on your Switch. Mark mentioned drift there, and the problem is real, unfortunately, especially if you bought one of the original models. So how do you solve this frustrating problem? Well, Mark has found the answer. Does it come from China? No, it does not. It comes from your local supermarket, and it is a can of WD-40.
Yeah, WD-40 contact cleaner, £5 on Amazon. Spray it into your drifting analog stick, and Bob's your uncle, or at least for about a week, and then you're probably back to square one. Thanks so much for watching. We've really enjoyed making this slightly different video. Let us know down in the comments if there are accessories that we've forgotten. There's probably some absolute clangers we've missed out on, but yeah, let us know down in the comments.
Yeah, for obvious reasons, we haven't mentioned official products because we're assuming that most people would know of those and they'd probably be your first port of call. But if you are looking to save a bit of money, or you're just unsure as to what other options you have, then some of these may be of interest to you.
A massive thank you to all the patrons who support us every single month, and for all things Switch all the time, keep it SwitchUp.
Good stuff. Yeah, thanks very much. Take it easy, and until next time, happy gaming.
See ya!